Welcome to the Clinton Township Planning Commission meeting for Thursday, February 10th. For those of you that can stand, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Potter, if I call you madam, I am apologizing ahead of time. Mr. Potter is our new secretary.
Been called worse.
Mr. Potter, roll call, please.
Yes. Mr. Kurt.
Here.
Mr. DeMayo, I'll get there.
Here.
Mr. Harris.
Here.
Mr. Hubler.
Here.
Ms. Mosley.
Here.
Ms. Patton.
Here.
Mr. Potter's here, and Mr. Wade.
Here.
Mr. Thompson is also here.
Thank you. Next item is the approval of the agenda. Are there any additions or deletions? If there are none, is there a motion?
I'll make a motion.
I'll second it.
Roll call, please.
Who's second? I'm sorry.
Mrs. Patton, second.
Okay.
Mr. D made the motion.
Okay, Ms. Patton. Mr. Kurd.
Yes.
Mr. DeMayo.
Yes.
Ms. Patton.
Yes.
I'll get there. Mr. Harris.
Yes.
Mr. Hubler.
Yes.
Ms. Mosley.
Yes.
Mr. Potter votes yes. Mr. Sasson.
Yes.
And Mr. Wade.
Yes.
Motion passes.
Thank you. Next on the agenda is the tree removal plan. This is for StoryPoint of Clinton Township Senior Living Facility. And just for our new planners with regard to our tree removal plans, the Planning Commission can approve or deny those removals. They do not have to go before the Board of Trustees. Mr. Potter, is there correspondence?
395 mailed, 14 returned.
Thank you. Mr. Thompson?
Actually, just for the record, we don't send notification out on the tree permit requests. There are times when the tree permit removal requests will come through with the site plan approval, and obviously, as you know, this board, this commission had reviewed the rezonings and the site plans for both these developments, both the Story Point of Clinton Township and the Maple Ridge development a couple of months back, and we just have not been able to get these on the agenda subsequently. But those were approved by both those developments were approved by the Township Board, and so this is just basically the last step for really both of these cases. And in fact, I'm going to just use the same image for both, because obviously these sites really at one point were one site, and now they are two. And so overall, when you look at the tree survey that was provided, and it was provided with the initial site plan, there are 400 trees on this site. These are not natural wooded areas. These are trees that were planted when this site was developed some time ago. Be that as it may, there are 400 mature trees. You can recall, for those planning commissioners that were here at the time of review, both of these developments contain, their approval contain large amounts of landscaping. And in fact, the Story Point, which I believe is the first one on the agenda, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. They are proposing to plant just themselves almost as many trees as are being taken out by the entire, on the entire site. They're proposing 356 trees just to be planted on their, oops, touchy mouse, on their site, and that's this area, what would be the northwest corner of the overall site off of 19 Mile Road, and over 2,000 shrubs and trees. So there's a substantial amount of landscaping being provided just on this one site, and obviously as a result, we're recommending that the Planning Commission approve the tree removal permit for Story Point. Thank you.
Thank you. Do we have the petitioners present for this matter?
Yes.
Do you have anything you'd like to add?
I do not.
Thank you. Is there anyone in our audience that would like to speak to this matter?
What, isn't it, is that Jim George?
Mm-hmm.
Questions or comments from our commissioners at this time? If there are no questions or comments from our commissioners, is there a motion?
I'll make a motion.
I'll support. Kurd?
Roll call, please.
Mrs. Patton?
Yes.
Mr. Kurd?
Yes.
Mr. DeBartolomeo?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Mr. Hubler?
Yes.
Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
Mr. Potter votes yes. Mr. Sasson?
Yes.
Mr.
Thank
Wade?
You. Oh, sorry.
Yes.
Chief Wade, I'm sorry. You're all the way down there at the end of the alphabet. Thank you.
Motion.
The motion passes. For the tree removal plan for StoryPoint of Clinton Township Senior Living Facility. Next item is the is also a tree removal plan for Maple Ridge Condominiums. Mr. Thompson,
yeah,
same
just,
speech?
Sure, just, yeah, basically the same thing. And I think really just to add it all up, there's going to be 799 trees planted on this site, which is a substantial amount given these developments. But the developer obviously took into account the screening for the homes to the west, or to the east, excuse me, to the condominiums to the south, went above and beyond landscaping requirements. So we have a total of this overall site, 799 trees and over 4,000 shrubs and flowering plants that are going to be planted. So it obviously far exceeds what is being removed. So again, in this particular case, we are as well recommending approval. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Thompson. No questions or comments?
No.
Questions or comments from our audience? If there are no questions or comments from our audience, commissioners, questions, comments? If there are none, is there a motion?
I'll make a motion for to approve the tree removal plan for Maple Ridge Condominiums.
I'll second.
Roll call, please. That was Mr. Sasson.
Thank you. Ms. Patton?
Yes.
Mr. Sasson?
Yes.
Mr. Kurd?
Yes.
Mr. DeBartolomeo?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Mr. Hubler?
Yes.
Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
Mr. Potter votes yes. And Mr. Wade?
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you. This motion also passes. And good
Thank
luck
you.
To you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We appreciate you. The next item on our agenda is a proposed rezoning from RML Multiple Family Residential Low Density to B3 General Business. This is 6.350 acres of land fronting the west side of Garfield Road, north of 18 Mile Road. This is part of Parcel 16-1107. Mr. Potter, is there correspondence?
This is your correspondence. 395 mailed, 14 returned.
395, 14
mailed.
Returned.
Correct.
And if I may, Madam Chairman?
Please, Mr. Thompson.
We did receive a written correspondence from Mr. C's Car Wash, Vito Catalfio.
Mm-hmm.
Pardon my pronunciation if I got that wrong. And then there was, as well, an additional correspondence that I emailed to the Planning Commission this morning from the petitioner. So the Planning Commission did receive those both correspondences prior to the meeting.
Okay, we don't need to read those
no,
into the record.
No,
okay.
That was something we did only when we were a virtual meeting.
Thank you.
So,
anything to add, Mr. Thompson?
I do, yes, thank you. I know, Madam Chairman, you want to speak a bit to the history of this site because there's been a lot of review and approvals on this site in the past, and so I'll defer to you after I just give the general description. And what we have here is the petitioner looking to rezone a portion of the property that is out there now, 4.04 acre portion of what is 6 1/3 acres. That 6 1/3 acres includes all of the property except for the extreme corner. That corner was approved for commercial development under a conditional zoning agreement. Through the review of this commission and by approval of the Township Board. And obviously you've been out there and you know that is constructed, it's approved, and it's been there for some time. The remainder of the site is zoned RML, which is our multiple family low density. The petitioner's looking to rezone this portion of it. What's shown on the drawing they provided is parcel B and parcel C to a B3 designation, which is a similar designation to the extreme corner. And Obviously, you can see they're looking to develop what is a proposal for a car wash and what would be an additional commercial site. And then, if you recall, previously, there was a 56-unit condominium development on this overall property that was approved. I went through site development plan approval, and they're looking at scaling that back along the west side of the property. That area would remain the current RML zoning designation. So based on that information, the planning department obviously took a look at this and reviewed it. Our opinion is such that the property can be clearly developed under its current zoning designation. Obviously, there's been an approved plan for residential use of this property, and so it can be developed that way. Second consideration, we feel that the proposed rezoning would result in a development that would not be compatible with the adjacent condominiums, the adjacent residential uses, and realistically would not be compatible with the proposed uses that as far as the multiple family that they have on this sketch plan that they've provided. The master plan, our future land use map of the Clinton Township master plan designates this property for multiple family use. The current zoning represents that, and we feel that it would be appropriate to leave it that way. That's what the master plan indicates. The sketch by the petitioner does propose an auto wash. Development of this type, we feel, will result in an increase in predominance of auto-related uses. Auto wash is obviously one, but others that are within this corridor, and even, again, potentially the auto wash that's directly across the street. It certainly presents a potential increase in traffic to the area compared to the approved previous use in the current zoning. In addition, we feel the proposed car wash has potential to present a nuisance to the adjacent residential area in the terms of noise. Therefore, this administration and planning department are recommending that the Planning Commission forward a recommendation for denial of this proposed rezoning from RML to B3 for those reasons stated. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Thompson.
And I did, Madam Chair, I'm sorry. I just did have one more image I wanted to show. It was provided by the petitioner, and that is a rendering of those units that they're conceptually proposing along this west side. So I just wanted to provide that. I also did have the previously approved plan if there was any need to reference that. So thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Thompson. So Mr. DeBartolomeo and myself were the only two commissioners that are still here that remember what went on with this site starting back in 2017. So we pulled the minutes, and I'm just going to go through those minutes just to give you a brief overview of the discussion that we had back then. So our first meeting minutes that we have are for August 24th. And at that time, the petitioner stated that their plan was to break the property into two zonings, but instead of an office, they were seeking approval to change the current multiple family low density residential to a higher density. They also said that they would build high end three-story apartment buildings that will be a complement to the area. We were assured at that time that they're not looking at high rise, but it would be a nice product that was attractive for that particular intersection. They also stated on the preliminary plan, and he explained that they are looking to provide a 35-foot buffer between the proposed development and the condominiums that were abutting that development. Three two-story buildings abutting the existing condos and three additional buildings towards Garfield with a center walkway. At the corner of Garfield and 18 Mile, they were proposing a 5,300 square foot convenience store with fueling spaces. We were also assured at that time that the proposed development would not be connected in any way to the abutting residential area. I guess there has been an issue with, you know, people that cut through in order to avoid traffic. So there would be no interconnecting road, and access to and from the property will be from two access points along Garfield Road and two along 18 Mile Road. He also reiterated these are not high-rise buildings, but will range from 30 to 32 feet in height. He explained that multifamily residential high density would allow for a development of condominiums, apartments, townhomes, and the units could be sold or rented. They anticipated that the apartments would lease for $1,100 for a one-bedroom unit and $1,500 for a two-bedroom unit. They were also going to create a courtyard with gardens, walkways, and units and balconies. we were hesitant, or one of our planning commissioners was hesitant to rezone that parcel to high density without knowing at that time what they were going to put in there. He also said that the RML would not give them a density that would be sufficient for the property at that location. He also explained that the portion of the property proposed for high density multiple family is about 7 acres, so they were somewhat limited as to what they could do. We also discussed a planned development, a planned unit development. The petitioner actually discussed it, and you know where he felt that the developer could go in and craft a project that was good for everyone. Then a conditional rezoning was put on the table, and you know they wanted to set definitive agreed upon items pursuant to the request that they were seeking. He also agreed to a meeting with the residents, and we always encourage our developers to meet with the residents, you know, so that they can kind of sort of have a meeting of the minds. And that did happen. That meeting went well with the residents at that time. He said he was limited to the type of design. With the three stories, they can become creative with the elevation. The apartments would range in size from 950 feet to 1,400 square feet because at that time he felt that's what was in demand, and the two-bedroom units would have two master suites to meet the demand of the marketplace. And last, for our meetings on our meeting minutes of August 24th, at that time, the further consideration of this matter, we decided that we were going to postpone it to have the petitioners meet with the representatives from the community. And that was on August 24th. We met again on August 10th. The meetings aren't that long, so I'm going to spare you guys. So at that time, they came and they requested a conditional rezoning of that parcel. And the small portion of that parcel was to remain zone RML, family residential, low density. At that time, they were going to come back with plans for residential development in the future, and we did approve that conditional rezoning. Mr. DeBartolomeo, if I missed anything, please let me know. And Mr. D sat on the Zoning Board of Appeals, so he can probably give us a little information with regard to that as well.
Yes, so the this matter came before the ZBA back on December 18th of 2018, and this was after the conditional approval was made by the Planning Commission. And because there were many variances that the developer was asking for, and there wasn't really a full agreement, there was some feedback from the residents as well as the ZBA members, it was felt again that we should postpone this, let the developers sit down with the residents as well as our director of planning. So we postponed it, and it came back before us then on February 20th of 2019. At that time, it was whittled down to like five variances, and it was basically all variances pertaining to the north and west borders as far as the footage away from the buildings and what have you. And everybody was in agreement. The residents were satisfied, the developer was satisfied, and the ZBA commission was satisfied as well.
Thank you. With that being said, the petitioner is present for this matter.
Yes. Good evening. Bob Kirk, 19500 Hall Road, Clinton Township, Michigan. Thank you for the history. I wasn't involved at that time. What we're requesting today is exactly what Bruce has said, is to change the zoning in the two parcels on the Garfield end and continue with the residential as previously planned on the west end. With regard to the residential, and it hasn't been built, as time goes on, we've determined that we don't think it's developable as planned. The plan that was approved has decks backing up to Garfield, other units also get really close to Garfield. In addition, the traffic pattern, there was an access off of Garfield and 18, which would allow cut through traffic. My clients have talked to other real estate gentlemen or real estate consultants and didn't think it was feasible to develop that type of condominium or unit with the traffic pattern as it was and the proximity to Garfield. So for that reason, they're asking that this be considered. It's a B3 use. We aren't asking for any specific uses at this time. It would provide for two commercial sites with only one access. I know Garfield has a ton of access points and curb cuts. This would only provide for one. It'd be a shared between the two. The 19 units would remain along the west end, which would buffer the existing condominiums to the west. The B3 request is consistent with all four corners of this area. In addition, you mentioned the master plan. If you look at the master plan, this is kind of like a spot zone. I don't know how this got to be master plan residential multiple. If you look in Garfield, pretty much all the way north, it's all commercial from that point. We feel the use is compatible. The property to the north, although that sliver is zoned RML, north of that we have the Country Inn, we have the Kentucky Fried Chicken, we have the Kmart, which I think is going to include a gas station soon. So we think these type of uses would be consistent. The plan is not to build another strip center. We know we have a lot of those along Garfield right now. The plan is to build some type of single uses along there. We think with the single access, there wouldn't be that much difference in traffic than the 36 units that would be cutting out of this project. With regard to potential nuisances, that is why we've left that buffer to the residential on the west end. In addition, we can propose, once we get the site plan, if we ever did, some increased buffering and landscaping along those. As I said, I think the master plan, although it's master plan for residential, if you look at it, it's the only one all along Garfield, any kind of vacant property that's master planned that way. So for those reasons, we believe our B3 zoning is appropriate for this area, and the parcel to the west remain RML.
Thank you, Mr. Kirk.
Thank you.
This is not a public hearing. However, we will allow you all to...
It actually is a public hearing.
I'm sorry. Okay, this
sorry.
Is a public hearing. So at this time, is there a motion to open the public hearing?
I'll make a motion to open up the public hearing.
Second. I'll support.
Roll call, please.
Who
Ms.
supported?
Ms. Patton.
Who supported?
Yeah, Mr. Kirk.
Thank you. Ms. Patton?
Yes.
Mr. Kirk?
Yes.
Mr. Deeb?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Mr. Hubler?
Yes.
Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
Mr. Potter votes yes. Mr. Sasson?
Yes.
And Mr. Wade?
Yes.
Thank you. The way we'll conduct our public hearing, we will allow each of you 3 minutes to speak. We will start on this side of the audience, and we'll go row by row. And when you are asking questions or making comments, if you could please pose those questions to myself and the commissioners, and I'll make notes the best I can. So once we get through all of the public comments, then from the notes, we'll go from there and get any questions answered for you all. So starting on this side of the audience, is there anyone in that third row that would like to speak to this matter?
Here.
Anyone in the fourth row to speak to this matter? Anyone in the fifth row to speak to this matter? I don't want you guys to be shy. Once we get that first person, I think that's kind of sort of the icebreaker, and then everybody is going to want to speak. And if you could, sir, please state your name and address for the record.
Hello, Madam Chairman. My name is Brian Charette. I live at 16630 Brookwood.
Drive in Garfield Manor. Speaking from what I can tell from talking with the neighbors and everything, our concerns with this development is the barrier between what is going to be built and our condominium complex. We've heard various things mentioned in the past, from a wall to, you know, a tree line or shrubs or, you know, a hill there or whatever. It's never been really clear what is actually going to be done. We would really like to know, you know, what is going to go in that little segment. And then the other things we worry about are, is obviously traffic to and from 18 Mile from our perspective, given the amount of traffic that's there already. I can understand where the developer's coming from with the business aspect of what he's talking about right there. The other concern would be looking at the condo units. You know, if that section gets taken up with business as well, that would be obviously a real problem for us. And the other thing would be noise. You know, we'd worry about businesses coming in with, you know, if they did build a car wash or something like that, you worry about noise, you know, in our close proximity to our residents. So those are the things we're worried about. I hope you can take all that into consideration.
Thank you, Brian. We appreciate your comments. Is there anyone else in that back row that would like to speak to this matter? You wanted the first question, I remember. Come on up and state your name and address for the record, please.
I'm Vito Cattelfield with Mr. C's Car Wash at 41200 Hayes Road. Feel very lucky today. 50 years ago, I met my wife. So I feel everybody's going to go my way.
Congratulations to you.
I'm the richest man here. I got four beautiful kids, married to four beautiful people. I got 12 grandkids.
Nice.
And I expect to have, in fact, a couple of them when they were younger, I thought they're probably going to go to jail. So I want to make sure I have a business for them to work in, okay? Tidal Wave is the sixth largest car wash in the country. They proposed to put a car wash directly across from Hannah Car Wash, okay, which is like kicking you in the teeth. I'm a mile up. As far as the model of Tidal Wave, Frank, Tuma with Cleanview has the same platform. Greenway has the same platform. As far as serving the public, that type of wash is well served. The Tumas just bought Robin's Car Wash. They're going to put another identical type of car wash there. I went down Sunday. I drove down Garfield. Just in my truck, I counted 47 vacancies. Now, of course, they're great people. The father, Frank, I thought was a great guy. But, hey, someone gets land at a cheaper price, there's people stuck with would love to sell. I know I'm going to get my butt kicked one day with Tidal Wave and these guys. But there's commercial land out there that they got to pay the premium. Okay, and to put this Tidal Wave here on cheaper land, and there's 14 car washes right now, okay? I don't want to cut the pie anymore. I don't even want to cut the pie with them. But, hey, you know, now I'm going to take another sliver out and let someone rezone the property. Please, stick with the master plan, I hope. Thank you.
Thank you. We appreciate your comments. Is there anyone else in that row that would like to speak to this matter? If you could, sir, state your name and address for the record, please.
Hi, my name is Robert Gunn. I live at 38109 Santa Ana. Full disclosure, my son is the owner of Wash Point Car Wash at Garfield and Metro Parkway. But I'm here to speak as a resident. I kind of have a unique perspective. I've been on both ends of this debate. When I started my career in the 70s, I had a car wash in East Point, and I lived directly behind that car wash. Initially, I was young, married, just starting out, had a couple of small children, and this house came up for sale. So I made a lowball offer, 20% below market value, and the guy said, of course, he said no. 6 months later, he comes back because nobody wants to live next door to a car wash. And he says, is that offer still stand? I said, sure, you know, and it worked out well for me. I lived there for 12 years, and on the one hand, yes, great living next door to your business. On the other hand, when you're in your backyard and some kids are over there and their boom boxes are really loud, you have the noise problem. It is an issue. Every car wash that has outdoor vacuums has this problem. So when you're close to a residential area, it's going to be a problem. I lived there for 12 years and moved out. At that point in time, I found out the other side of the equation. I got a good deal buying that house. I didn't get a good deal when I sold that house because, like I said, it will affect property values on nearby properties. That's just a fact of life with a car wash. It's a unique type of business. It's not like a storefront that may have an occasional delivery truck at the back door. It's people outdoors working on their cars. It's almost a party atmosphere at sometimes. If you have self-serve vacuums, you're going to have a noise issue. And that's the issue, only issue I wanted to bring up.
Thank you, Mr. Gunn. We appreciate your comments. Is there anyone else in that row that would like to speak to this matter? Is there anyone in the next row that would like to speak to this matter? And anyone in the last row that would like to speak to this matter? Come on up, sir. State your name and address for the record, please.
How you doing? My name's Brian Neenstead. I'm at 41200 Garfield Road. I got Hannah Car Wash. They already made a lot of some of the same points. We know there's auto businesses all up and down Garfield, whether it be the mechanics and all that. We need a little diversity in there for all of us to succeed, you know. So I don't want to repeat a lot of what they were saying, but to the point that they were making about why they don't want it residential and backing up to Garfield, the decks and whatnot, if you look at just the opposite side of 18 Mile and Garfield, we have a developed corner and then right to residential, and it backs right up to Garfield. Hasn't been a problem for 30 years. So with the high demand for residential, I really think it should stay zoned residential. When you add all the vacancies in commercial and the 6, 7, 8, 10 car washes in the area, we don't need more vacant lots. What our township, I believe, needs is more residential. Everybody knows right now, if you go to sell a house, it's gone in seconds for $40,000 over asking price. Why would this property be any different? What do those people do? They support our community with tax dollars, our local businesses. They help fill those 47 vacant commercial, you know, open lots that need to be filled. We need residents. We need people that contribute. That's it. So I hope you guys keep it zoned residential. We need it.
Thank you, Brian. Thank you. Appreciate your comments.
Yep.
All right. Is there anybody that was too shy out there to speak the first time? Come on up, sir, and state your name and address for the record, please.
I've never been accused of being shy.
Oh, that's a good thing.
My name is Chris Harris. I've had the pleasure of owning and operating the Midas Auto Facility across the street for 30-some-odd years. Officially, I'd like to thank the township for finally getting our road repaired. It's been a wonderful addition to our business district, and just say thanks to the township for helping make that happen. I would like to just repeat a lot of what's been said. We have been community partners with the residents that live in those condos for the entire time that we have been there. They've been wonderful people to work with. We know most of them. If you go through those condo units, there's very little turnover, and when a unit does go up for sale, it sells very quickly. There is a large demand for those types of units in that area. We were thrilled when the last proposal came through when they were discussing putting a condo development in there. We were really hoping that was the way you guys were going to go. Unfortunately, that didn't seem to work out. I do want to reiterate the vacancy rate. Obviously, we're in a unique position as business is these days. But if you go up and down Garfield, as Mr. C pointed out, there are several vacant areas, including the development that they just put at 18 in Garfield, where the Dunkin' Donuts is, that building that's yet to be at full capacity. There may be plans to do so, but as of now, it continues to stand vacant in the middle. We don't know what's happening with the Kmart property. That's been vacant for some period of time. The strip mall across where the Noki restaurant is continues to remain vacant. The development at 19 in Garfield continues to remain vacant. The Apple Annie's strip mall continues to remain largely vacant. The college, the strip mall across from the college down the north end of 19 Mile Road continues to remain half vacant. It's not an easy time right now. It wasn't designed as general business, and we don't support that concept. The other thing, Brian mentioned diversification. We had an issue recently, as everyone may know, when Firestone came in across the street from us. We brought this issue up at that time regarding, we understand the need for business and the different types of businesses that are available to our residents. They don't all have to be the same types of businesses directly across the street from each other. Those businesses have been there for a long time. It's been a struggle at times to survive, especially given the current circumstances, and more competition doesn't help. It obviously doesn't help. So we would appreciate your consideration in the matter of leaving it the way that it was zoned per the general master plan, and I appreciate your time.
Thank you, Mr. Harris. We appreciate your comments. Now, once we close the public hearing, there we don't typically allow any more comments, so make sure you guys get it out. Come on, sir, if you could step up and state your name and address for the record, please.
Hi, how are you? My name is Adam Hasek. My address is 40817 Garfield. I own Glitz and Ears. Anything I have to add to this is going to be redundant of what these gentlemen and ladies have said, but I just wanted to state my opinion as well that, you know, we need more residents who are going to be paying customers for businesses like us who have had a very difficult time surviving through this. We love the township, but we, you know, I speak for, I think, a lot of businesses. We need less vacancies, commercial vacancies. We need more residents bringing people into the community that are going to support and add something of value to the community. And again, you know, it seems like there's a magnitude of very like businesses around the area. So if it, you know, was business, it should be something much more diverse than what is being proposed. So I would like to see the master plan. I think it was a good plan initially. So that's what I would like to see happen. Thank you.
Thank you, Adam. We appreciate your comments. Is there, okay, come on up, ma'am. State your name and address for the record, please.
Good evening, everyone. Gail Savocchio at 16545 Dawn Drive in Clinton Township at Garfield Manor at 18 in Garfield. To reiterate what everyone has said, I totally 100% agree that we need more residential for our community, and, you know, just to keep on doubling up on these businesses like the, you know, all these, like Midas spoke about with the other tire company or the other business across the street, and then another car wash across from the other car wash. It's kind of like duplicating everything. And we back up to that Garfield. The buffers that they put in for the corner unit for the Dunkin' and the other establishment.
FedEx.
There's no real buffer. And they're widespread. And they're pretty much half dead. So, you know, what they talked about, they were going to have the buffers. And that was my concern about that, because they're just too far apart. I thought a buffer would be where it would separate us, which hasn't. So that's really another one of my concerns. And I'm concerned about the noise and also the establishment being so close to our community as residents. And our community, those condos go quick. So there's no problem with getting residents in this community. It's a really good community to be here. I've been here for 18 and a half years. Thank you for your consideration.
Thank you, Gail. Any other shy people in our audience that want to step up and speak to this matter?
Hello. Good evening. I'm Jeff Baldwin, owner operator of Jay Baldwin's restaurant on 16981 18 Mile for the last 18 years. I'm going to reiterate what they pretty much what they said. But as far as residential, we definitely need more residential in the area. And maybe a solution to the drive-through problem is make it a gated community, possibly. Other than that, but I don't think we need any more commercial on that corner anyways, all the way down Garfield for that matter.
Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you.
We appreciate your comments. Anyone else in our audience want to speak to this matter? Questions, comments? If there are no other questions or comments from our audience, is there a motion to close the public hearing?
I'll make a motion to close the public hearing.
Support. Support.
Roll call, please.
Who supported? I'm sorry.
Mr. DeBartolomeo.
Thank you. Ms. Patton.
Yes.
Mr. Dee.
Yes.
Mr. Kurt.
Yes.
Mr. Harris.
Yes.
Mr. Hubler.
Yes.
Ms. Mosley.
Yes.
Mr. Potter votes yes. Mr. Sasson.
Yes.
And Mr. Wade.
Yes.
Thank you.
Madam Chair, can I just respond to a couple of things?
Sure. Come on up, Mr. Kurt.
Thank you. Just a couple of the items. Our request, as we said before, is not use specific as to the car wash. With regard to vacancy, it is not our intent to build a multi-unit strip center. We are looking for individual users on these, which cannot be serviced by some of these other strip centers that are currently vacant. With regard to the buffering, we're open to more buffering with regard to berming or landscaping along the west end of our property. And as the said before, the units that would be backing up to Garfield, I mean, we're concerned we couldn't sell those or sell them at such a price that would devalue the whole project. And in addition, two of the other buildings are really close to Garfield. So that's been the concern we've come across with regard to the project that had previously been approved. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kirk. And just as a reminder, this is a request for rezoning. So that's, you know, what our focus is this evening. As far as, you know, what's going to go in there, you know, until we actually have a site plan, you know, we don't know what's going to go in there. But at this time, I will defer to our commissioners for any questions and comments. Go ahead, Mr. Kerr.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I'm curious about the history of the site. Was this at one time an entire site? So we've got the Dunkin' Donuts down in the lower right there. And then, so that's what that parcel A. So then we're talking about rezoning B and C.
Mm-hmm.
And then D would remain RML, and there'd be some residential development there. So parcel A, where the Dunkin' Donuts and the FedEx Kinko's, was that initially part of the same parcel? Is it owned by someone else, or is it owned by the same people?
That I don't remember. Ron, do you remember?
I think it's all the same. Yeah, it's all the same.
Okay, so that corner came before, would have kind of come before us, or was, do we know if it was always B3?
No, it initially, if you don't mind, Madam Chairman, I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
The overall property was zoned RML.
Mm-hmm.
The initial rezoning request came in from RML to RMH and B3.
Mm-hmm.
B3 for the corner, RMH for the apartments. As the chair had indicated, there was some, you know, discussions and changes. It went to B3. This was basically the proposal that ended up. Was rezoned to B3 under a conditional rezoning. This area stayed RML. They redesigned, went from apartments to condominiums. As Mr. DeBartolomeo had said, there were some variances that were involved in that. But this was the proposal that it, kind of everybody had agreed to, everybody being the Planning Commission, petitioner, the folks from the condominiums, all of that. So that this area stayed RML. This is the only area where the zoning changed. But initially, it was all one parcel.
All RML. Okay, thank you.
Any other questions or comments from the commissioners? Ron?
Yeah. I remember this vividly. There was a lot of discussion from a lot of the residents at the time when this first came to us in 17. And at the time, when they were asking for the rezoning 3, they proposed a gas station. And they proposed just not a typical gas station, but one to be with convenience in today's, what we see in today when we go to one of these newer gas stations. The residents, as well as the commission, wasn't too thrilled about a gas station. There was a lot of dialogue between the developers and the residents, and I give a lot of kudos to the developer for sitting down as many times he did with the residents to come to a happy medium. I think in hindsight, the developer probably made a mistake in not asking for B3 on those two parcels back then in 2017. Times were good then. They wanted apartments at the time. Again, the residents were objecting to that. The developers and the planning director and the residents sat down, and again, they came to a happy medium to do condos, 56 units. Like I said, there were variances that were given. One of the issues that was talked about during that time was that intersection. There were two gas stations. There are two gas stations. There are other businesses. We talk about a lot with the traffic that is still exists there today. The residents had a lot of concern because if you go to a street or two behind Kroger's on Canal, you can traverse from Canal to 18 and vice versa and going through those condos. And there was a lot of traffic that was happening there because people were avoiding Garfield because of the traffic and that intersection. That hasn't changed. You know, whether it's a car wash or not, I think any type of automotive should not be put into that area at all. It's just going to cause more traffic than what we already have. At the February 20th ZBA meeting, there were a couple of interesting, and that's where we granted the variances. There was a resident by the name of Mr. Dean Enrici who got up and, you know, and some of his comments were, and he praised the developers for the many drawings to appease the residents. The developer met with the residents many times. The developer has done a lot for us, meaning the residents, and he's done everything for us. And he had nothing but praise for the development that was going to occur, as we saw earlier, with the condominiums. And then, Mr. Harris, you spoke at that meeting as well. And as a business owner, you were very happy with the changes because you mentioned then more residents were coming into that area. And Mr. Tim Ponton, who from Stonefield Engineering, who was really representing the developers during all of these different hearings, was talking about the 56 units, two bedrooms, two baths, 1,700 to 1,800 square feet, and they were going to sell between 200 and 250,000. And he said they'll fly, you know, being in the northern part of the area, and he thought it was a good make. And then we also told our chair, the ZBA, mentioned to the developers, Mr. Ponton, that the variances are locked in, you know, that you got to live with them, and everybody agreed. And at that particular one, even everybody went away happy, you know, and we waited and still waiting. And they're coming back now, and I know the pandemic has done things differently, you know, has changed things, I understand, and manufacturing and what have you. But to open this up to B3, I mean, we wouldn't allow the gas station there because of the traffic and all. And, you know, should this be a car wash, which everyone seems to intimating it would be, you know, you have one way coming in and another way coming out. How do you turn left? I was thinking about this. If you're coming out of the exit, you could turn right to go south on Garfield. But how would you, because it's right there at the intersection for all intents and purposes, how would you turn left mm-hmm. if you needed to go north? Mm-hmm. Be very difficult with that mm-hmm. intersection. I just think too little, too late. I don't know. I think the condos, I think it's still a very good piece of property over there. And I think it's a very valuable piece of property where residents would like to come in. In fact, I remember Mr. Ponton even saying that there was waiting lists of 100 to 150 people trying to get in to various areas of Clinton Township. So I myself, And then the other part is the integrity and a trustworthiness. You know, this is the ninth time that this has come before us or ZBA or the Board of Trustees. And it's like, all right, what's the bottom line? What do you really want here? I mean, you gave us our word. You gave us the word to the residents what you wanted to do. We all believed in you. We had faith in you. We trusted you. For me to go back, and I voted for the conditional rezoning. I voted for the proposal that was given. And for me to now say to rezone to B3, I'm going back on my word now from what was originally given. I can't do that. So I will tell you that if there is a motion for B3, I will have to vote against it, just based on the history in the past, based on everything that had transpired in the past, and based on what my knowledge and what I voted on in the past.
Thank you, Ron. And if I could just piggyback on that, B3 is such an intense use. It could be a gas station, it could be a car wash, you know, another drive-through. It's very, very intense. And, you know, we're talking about a rezoning, and the petitioner does not have to put in a car wash. You know, if we decide that we wanted to rezone it, they could really come back and say, hey, you know, we want to put a gas station in. So that it's just a really very, very intense use. And with regard to the master plan, to me, the master plan is like a bachelor's degree or a master's degree. You know, you go find a job and they say, hey, you know, you need a bachelor's degree to be able to make coffee. But do you really need a bachelor's degree, you know, to be able to make coffee? You don't always need a bachelor's degree. Sometimes, you know, if I want to work in the IT department, okay, maybe I do need a bachelor's degree. You know, so with regard to the master plan, you know, people think that, you know, the master plan is the master plan, you know, and that's what it says, you know, but sometimes, you know, you just have to look at each individual event, you know, and figure out, you know, what is best in that situation. I would be, personally, I would be hesitant to go with the B3, only because it is a very, very intense, you know, option, you know, that they have. And the traffic on Garfield, it can already be a nightmare. You know, a lot of times I have to turn right to go left, you know, because I can't safely turn left, you know. Everybody doesn't do that. You know, some people still try to turn left, you know. So if you're trying to turn left, you know, you've got five cars behind you, you know, that are trying to go right. Well, they can't get out. You know, now everybody's honking at everybody and giving each other the finger, you know. So I would be, you know, just a little hesitant to, you know, go B3 with this. But, you know, I would like to hear, you know, any other comments, you know, from the commissioners? And I see a hand in the audience. And typically, you know, since we do have a motion on the table, we don't usually break that motion. But did you have something?
I'm part of the development team of the property.
Okay.
I wanted to speak my mind.
If
I may, of course.
Okay, so if you all don't have any objection, you know, if my commissioners are okay with that, then yeah. And when you say speak your mind, well, you know, just, don't be mad out there in the audience. Go ahead.
Thank you for allowing me the opportunity. My name is Frank R. Corey from Veris Development Group. Address 36400 Woodward Avenue, Suite 240, Bloomfield Hills. I'm here on behalf of our Veris Development Group just to tell you that we've been a great team member to the community for a number of years. This is not our first time, obviously, before you. When you question our integrity, I took offense to that. Now, with that being said, we, you know, for a number of years, we went above and beyond to speak to the neighbors in regards to what we felt would be best for this corner. And I like to think that we did a very good job in being able to accommodate everybody's requests and comments at what you guys see now at the corner of 18 and Garfield. With that being said, we obviously did have a plan to develop 56 or so condos, and through the due diligence of starting that project, you know, construction costs were quickly becoming astronomical to a point where we had to question if it would make, you know, the viability of the investment would make sense. We also encountered a pandemic that also, you know, put a huge wrench in our plans for this property. If I may repeat once again, we're proud developers of a number of properties up and down the Grossbeck corridor. At Cass and Grossbeck, we developed the Chipotle that just got completed. We developed the Aldi's, the Tim Hortons, and we like to think that we've been a great team member to the community, and that's the way we would do things. The reality is, in regards to the corridor, I mean, you know, it's no secret from 17 Mile all the way to basically Hall Road, it's all commercial. If we feel that an extra two or three users on the Garfield Road would cause such a negative impact, you know, I question, you know, new life, new energy, and you know, conducting the way we do things and elevate it, I think is, you know, competition is healthy. And a new, fresh life to the intersection, you know, I think will challenge other property owners to do, you know, to invest in their properties. You talk about 50 vacancies. It's like we need to invest in our properties to bring more people to the community, bring more tenants into these vacancies that are, you know, present in our neighborhood. So, you know, we look at competition as healthy because it keeps everybody honest. You know, the people talk about tidal wave. If you read about them, there are a green company who once again, they've elevated the way car washes are conducting themselves. And for the community, I think it's all positive. And, you know, we just hope that you consider, you know, we have a tough piece of property that we've been spending a number of years and a considerable amount of money. And, you know, we want to bring this project to fruition, and we want to put this to bed. So
thank you.
I appreciate you guys allowing me the opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, Frank. Next time, don't be shy.
Yeah.
All right. Any other questions, comments from the commissioners? Mr. Kirk.
Madam Chair, thank you. Just wanted to follow up. I have concerns about the vacancy, the existing business vacancies in the area, adding more places. And a good example, one of the businesses in the Dunkin' Donuts building just moved from across the street. So then, you know, we're just mm-hmm. kind of shell game. And so that concerns me. Auto business, kind of on the fence. You know, is it the best for the residents in the area? Is it the best for the community to put the auto business? I don't know. I'm kind of half and half. Not sure that a car wash is a good idea. Really, I guess my biggest concern is that the plans are a bit uncertain. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we've done all this work before. And I'm very sensitive to the idea that we have properties rights. You know, I own a piece of property, it's zoned a particular way, and I want to make sure that the owner of that property is allowed to do what they're allowed to do. Mm-hmm. We've had things come before us before where, especially in the case of a neighboring community, you have I built a house and the lot behind me was all wooded. And then the owner of that wooded lot decided, you know what, I'm going to knock down all the trees. I'm going to do something different. I'm going to put a subdivision in. People get upset, and it, you know, you have to balance that. I know you liked your view, but your neighbor, that's his property or her property, and they're able to do that. So we've got a property that was zoned RML. We've got a lot of work that went into that idea as RML. Developer, you guys came in and purchased that property with the intent of developing it as residential. I understand things change, but there's no, you know, if we're talking about rezoning, we have to have this conversation. And I'm just not, mm-hmm. I'm really not feeling it. And I don't know that, I don't think I'm going to support. If we have a motion to approve, I can't support it either. Just not enough. There are uncertainties. We've been round and round with it already. Would love to know more plans. I'm leaning toward leaving it residential. If the existing residential plan doesn't work, condos with a deck back to Garfield, let's rework the site plan. Real estate is good. It's a good market, and people are selling things quickly. So, anyway, those are my comments. I'm in favor of leaving it RML and not rezoning to B3, personally.
Thank you, Mr. Kurd. Any other questions or comments from our commissioners at this time? If there are no other questions or comments, is there a motion?
I'll make a motion to keep it RML instead of B3.
Okay, so we are going to make a motion to stay RML and not rezone to B3.
Correct.
I support.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Potter votes be yes on.
You, yeah,
Madam
yeah.
Chair, motion.
I'm sorry.
I didn't say anything.
Yes, your motion was to leave it RML and not rezone it to
correct.
B3.
So that would be yes.
So you're going to be yes,
yes
to the remaining RML.
RML, yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ms. Patton?
Yes.
Mr. Kirk?
Yes.
Mr. D?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Mr. Hubler?
Yes.
Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
Mr. Sasson?
Yes.
And Mr. Wade?
Yes.
Thank you. The motion passes to leave that parcel zoned RML. The request for rezoning to B3 has been denied. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you. Now, Madam Chair, if I'm... Yeah, this is a recommendation.
Yeah,
right? You are a recommending body.
Is a recommending
right.
body.
And so this case still does have to go in front of the Township Board.
Okay.
So it will be forwarded to the Township Board with your
final,
recommendation.
For their final recommendation. Yes. Absolutely. What date?
I do not have a date set yet.
Okay.
I think the... Give me just a moment.
Okay.
I usually write that down. We'd be looking at the 28th of February.
Oh, okay, so this meeting is going to be placed, this the agenda item will be placed on the meeting of February 28th?
Yes, ma'am.
February 28th. Thank you. Okay. Next item on the agenda is the proposed rezoning from B3 General Business to SP1 Special Purpose Nursing Home. This is 10.4 acres, Section 15, south of Cass Avenue, west of Grosbeck Highway. Mr. Potter, is there correspondence?
Yes, 142 mail, 57 return.
Mr. Thompson.
Thank you. This is a site I think that's familiar to some of the planning commissioners. It's part of a larger development that's occurred over time. It's actually one of the last remaining parcels in this area. It's south of the Meyer, west of Grosbeck. Mr. Arcorian indicated, they just built a Chipotle, just for reference, that's right here. So here's the Meyer, here's the Meyer gas station, the Aldi, the other commercial along Grosbeck Highway. But this is a 10-acre site. As you can see, I put up the aerial that they provided. It's a vacant property adjacent to the condominiums. This is a preliminary plan that was submitted by the petitioner. They're requesting to rezone this property from B3 to our SP1. This is the zoning that is necessary for the type of use they're proposing, which is a senior active adult living community. All of the previous areas around here that were part, it was actually part of a larger conditional rezoning, are zoned B3. The area to the west is zoned RML with the Hillcrest condominiums, just from a reference standpoint. They are looking at building a number of uses, basically what I like to call a continuum of care for our adult community. So everything from individual units, single family units and condo style, four unit buildings, two unit buildings, to a three story assisted living and memory care wing, as well as a four story independent living wing for this. Again, this is a site that's already integrated into a larger development, so it would have access directly to Grosbeck from what is called Church Street. It's actually a set of private drives. They are not roads, but the ordinance does allow access through private drive systems for these uses directly onto Grosbeck. The details of the site plan, we're actually currently going through a review of a site plan that the petitioner submitted. We're not able to submit them at the same time as the rezoning, but if the rezoning is approved, we will certainly be looking at bringing that site plan subsequently to this board. And we will definitely have a lot more detail as to
We have to keep the doors open.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, yes, please.
The future land use map, it does designate this for commercial use, but that we feel that the use that is proposed is much less intensive than might otherwise be developed under the B3 zoning. We also feel, again, that this rezoning will result in a development that provides for a continuum of housing needs for our aging population. And so as a result, we are recommending that the Planning Commission rezone this 10-acre property from B3 to SP1. It would not be detrimental to development trends in the area, and we believe will have a positive effect on public interest and development within this part of our community. I did want to show you, because we were going through site plan approval through the beginning processes, they did provide us with some elevations. So I did want to show you what the buildings might look like. I can tell you this is likely not to be the final renderings of what these buildings will look like, because we've had discussions about adding some additional masonry to these units. So you'll be seeing something a little bit different, but it is a similar design. Just like any other business, they have their look, right? They have their design. So that's the four-story building, which was the independent living, the three-story, which is assisted living memory care, and then the individual townhome, or not townhome units, but single-family units that buffer the larger buildings for the condos to the west. And that's all I have.
Thank you, Mr. Thompson. The petitioner is present for this matter. If you could, sir, please step up and state your name and address for the record, please.
Good afternoon, members of the commission. My name is Alejandro Fernandez. I'm with Stonefield Engineering Design, located over at 607 Shelby Street, Detroit, Michigan. With me is the applicant, Gary Biles, with Omni Property Companies, LLC. We're very happy to be in front of you tonight and take the initial steps towards what we believe is a great development and would be a great addition to the township. As Bruce mentioned, we're seeking a zoning map amendment of this 10-acre historically vacant lot south of the Meyer off Grosbeck. The proposed amendment to said parcel will change its zoning from current general business, B3, which is intended for high intensity uses, to a special purpose district, SP1, which is solely for senior residential developments, which in nature are of a less intense use. The approval of the requested amendment will allow us to bring forth a great project into this historically vacant parcel. This project will be a low traffic generator, and it will have a great positive benefit to all the surrounding properties. We expect that the active members of the future community will take full advantage of all the commercial uses around it, as well as the beautiful park to the south of it, the George Memorial Park. And this project will also function as the perfect buffer between the existing commercial developments along Grosbeck and the existing residential parcels to the west of our site. With that said, we're very happy to once again be in front of you and work within the Clinton Township and provide a great product that will benefit the whole community. We're more than happy to answer any questions you might have at the moment.
Thank you, Mr. Fernandez. This is also a public hearing. Is there a motion to open the public hearing?
I'll make a motion to open up the public hearing.
Support.
Roll call, please.
Ms. Patton?
Yes.
Mr. Sasson?
Yes.
Mr. Kurt?
Yes.
Mr. D?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Mr. Hubler?
Yes.
Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
Mr. Potter votes yes. And Mr. Wade?
Yes.
Thank you. Is there anyone in our, public audience that would like to speak to this matter? Seeing and hearing no one in our audience to speak to this matter, is there a motion to close the public hearing?
I'll make a motion to close the public hearing.
Support. Who is the support? Thank
was
you.
That you, Mr. Hubler?
Mr. Hubler?
Yes.
Support?
Roll call, please.
Mr. Hubler. Ms. Patton?
Yes.
Mr. Hubler?
Yes.
Mr. Kurd?
Yes.
Mr. D?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
Mr. Potter votes yes. Mr. Sasson?
Yes.
And Mr. Wade?
Yes.
Thank you. Questions or comments from our commissioners at this time?
I just had a quick question. If, with the complex being opened, you talked about George Park, would they have to go back onto Grosbeck and drive all the way around, or is there going to be another way for them to get to George Park?
So this is not the final plan that you're seeing here in front of you. This is a very preliminary plan. In the latest plan, we actually are proposing a sidewalk connection at the south of the property for active members to be able to walk into that park and connect to the trail that's just south of us.
Okay. Just pedestrian?
Yeah.
Okay.
Any other questions, comments from our commissioners at this time?
Yes, from the pictures that were shown, you had it going four stories. Now, do we have a height issue with the residential that's going to be butting up to on the other side? Is that a concern at all, or nothing to worry about? Are residents going to come out and if this goes, forward? Are they going to be concerned that they have blockage, this four-story building center going up in their backyard, basically?
If I could. My name's Gary Bialas, and I'm with Omni Properties. I'm Vice President of Development. We realized there was housing next to us. Once you see the topo and as we go forward our site plan, you'll see there's actually a big ditch, almost okay. A stream that's between us. And that's one reason I laid out, we call them villas, you call them townhouses, we call them villas, on that property line. So what they're going to be seeing is our villas that are a little up the hill from them. They're down here, our villas are here.
Okay.
They will see the top of this building, but I have an exhibit when we go to, I have to go to get a variance for height. That shows, I think, the closest unit is about 360 feet away from our building. So it's okay. Over a football field that this building will be away from them. And I think the transition from their, house with our villas buffering it, then this back that. Okay. It should, I hope, would be satisfactory to everybody.
Madam Chairman?
Seems like
sure. Mr. Thompson?
May I just add to that?
Sure.
Okay, so obviously, this administration's had a lot of discussion with Gary, and Alejandro's been involved in it in his group. We are going through the site plan right now. The idea is to go for site plan approval, as I'd indicated. They will need variances from the Zoning Board of Appeals because of the height of this particular building. The SP1 district allows three stories, 35 feet as the maximum height. But as you know, this type of development, and it's very similar to the first cases you saw today from Member StoryPoint, was as well. It was three stories, 30, but it wasn't 35 feet. I think the idea there, and Mr. DeBartolomeo obviously was at the zoning board meeting, is those height requirements are a bit archaic, right? For the type of use that this is and the type of height of the units, the interior units, the buildings just are taller. They're taller these days than they were before. But we did have that same discussion, Mr. Sasson, about height, and I'm going to agree, with him in the fact that there is quite a separation. I think putting the villas, I will call them villas from now on, I apologize, is a great buffer for that. And there is a great deal of topography on this property because it's adjacent to the river. There was some land that was built up. So when you factor that all in, and again, when you see the site plan when it comes forward, if it does, you'll see how that kind of plays out. Will there be some concern? Always, right? The neighbors want to know. I spoke to one of the condominium association representatives yesterday, but I think he was pretty pleased with this product on this site. So I think it's just something we'll have to wait and see. But this height is indicative of this type of use. Right.
So.
Anything else, Mr. Sasson?
No, thank you.
Any other questions or comments from the commissioners at this time?
I just had one.
Go ahead, Chief Wade.
If somebody was leaving the complex, do they have to drive back onto Grosbeck to go to Myers? Because I'm sure a lot of them will be shopping. Or are they going to be able to get on that feeder road behind?
This is actually, there's a road. If you look on this map to the top, the Myers is the Myers Road is the same road we get to our project from.
Okay.
So they never go out back on the road. They
perfect.
Interconnect.
Yeah, and there's a service drive, Madam Chairman, if I may, that really feeds the rear of all of these commercial uses. Okay. Obviously, Meyer fronts to that. But even if you go north of the gas station, there's a brand new small commercial power center being developed there that's going to have a Starbucks. That has access to the service drive behind. This overall development was designed as such to mitigate traffic with the understanding there were going to be a large number of uses that occurred on this overall acreage, because it's a lot of acreage. And so, in fact, Church Street is the light, right? So a vast majority of the folks that come through Meyer, the gas station, even a lot of these uses, especially if you're a regular customer there, which guilty is charged between the Meyer and the Jimmy John's and some of the others, I don't even try and go left. I out of there at some of these other service drives. I go to the light, and it's timed very well. And in fact, I had a discussion with MDOT initially when this proposal came along about traffic studies and the design, and they were more than comfortable in looking at this with the design and the light, that they didn't feel any kind of traffic study was necessary, or that this was going to provide any, you know, additional impact that would need mitigation from a traffic standpoint. So everything's already interconnected. It's one of those situations where you want to look at this and say, how do you want multiple use developments to occur from a traffic standpoint? This is a great example of connecting uses so they don't have to go on a Grosbeck. Mm-hmm. And our ordinance requires that for new development. Right. So it would be required of them anyway, but obviously that's already designed for them. They don't have to worry about that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you.
Any other questions or comments? Mr. Curd?
Just that I'm supportive. I think that the continuum of care from individual living up to, you know, advanced needs and assisted living and, you know, a good win for the community. It feels like it fits well in the footprint of the development and also in the neighborhood. So I'm supportive.
I agree.
Any other questions, comments from the commissioners?
I'll make a motion.
I'll support.
The motion I'll make is proposed rezoning from B3 to general business to SP1 special purpose, with the stipulation that the variances will be granted by the ZBA.
And I'll still support.
And Mrs. Patton supported that.
Yes.
Roll call, please.
Mr. D.
Yes.
Ms. Patton.
Yes.
Mr. Curd.
Yes.
Mr. Harris.
Yes.
Mr. Hubler.
Yes.
Mrs. Mosley.
Yes.
Mr. Potter votes yes. Mr. Sasson.
Yes.
And Mr. Wade.
Yes.
Thank you. The motion passes. The Planning Commission is a recommending body. This will be forwarded to the Township Board for their final consideration. Bruce, this is also going to be placed on the 28th, the meeting of the 28th, February 28th.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Good luck, you guys. Thank you.
Thank you so much, and have a good night.
Thank you.
Okay. Next on our agenda is the Planning Commission annual report. Mr. Thompson?
So I did make the changes that were discussed at the last meeting. I know you wanted the opportunity to review that document a little bit more for the new commissioners, just so that you understand the state statute, the zoning enabling and planning enabling legislation requires that this commission prepare and submit an annual report to the Township Board outlining all of your activities and the decisions made each and every calendar year. So that is what this is. As I had mentioned at the last meeting, last year was a substantial year for the Planning Commission, and is how many cases you heard. You actually more than doubled the two previous years combined. So it's good news for everybody. We're going to look forward to a busy 2022 as well.
Thank you. We need a motion to accept the Planning Commission annual report.
I'll make a motion to accept the annual report.
I'll support that motion. Roll call, please.
Ms. Patton?
Yes.
Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
Mr. Kurd?
Yes.
Mr. Deeb?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Mr. Hubler?
Yes.
Mr. Potter votes yes. Mr. Sasson?
Yes.
And Mr. Wade?
Yes.
Thank you. The motion passes. Next on our agenda is our public comments. Mrs. Wade, son Wade, any public comments from you all this evening? Thank you. Seeing no other questions or comments from our public, our public comment portion is closed. Next on the agenda is the report of the meetings. This is the minutes of the meeting for January 13th, 2022. Has everybody had a chance to review those minutes? Is there a motion?
I'll make a motion to accept the minutes.
I'll support, Kurd.
Roll call, please.
Mrs. Patton?
Yes.
Mr. Kurd?
Yes.
Mr. D?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Mr. Hubler?
The question, since I wasn't here, would it be proper to abstain?
Correct.
Please.
Okay, Mr. Hubler abstains. Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
Mr. Potter votes yes. Mr. Sasson?
Yes.
And Mr. Wade?
I wasn't here either.
So you'd be abstaining. Thank you.
I think the motion still passes.
It does.
It does.
To accept the minutes of the meeting, January 13th. Mr. Thompson, discussion on the next meeting?
So for the February 24th meeting, we do have two cases. One is a site that the Planning Commission saw some time ago. It's Union Lake Villas. It's an apartment complex proposal on the west side of Union Lake. It was actually approved in the past. They actually put the utilities in. And then the housing market tanked, and they were not able to complete that project. So the developer waited and waited and waited, and obviously the market has changed, and they came back. Unfortunately, the variances that applied to that site expired. The site plan was still good because they had pulled permits to do the site work. What we're bringing it back for as a revised site plan approval is because the plan changed at the Zoning Board of Appeals level. They reduced the number of units. There was concern at the public meetings or the public meetings of the Zoning Board about the amount of density that was being proposed. And so the petitioner asked that the item be postponed, came back after the new year, reduced the number of units. And so because of that change, we wanted to make sure that that was on the record. So that will be coming back to you as a revised site development plan approval. And just for the new commissioners, not unlike the tree permit application requests where the Planning Commission has sole discretion over those, the same is true with revised site plan approvals. Revised site plan approvals, sites that have already gotten site plan approval, but they want to make revisions to, those come to the Planning Commission and are approved or denied by the Planning Commission. They don't go to the board. Thank you for letting me give today's lesson, I guess. The second thing we have is the site plan for these gentlemen that you just recommended approval for the rezoning. They wanted to kind of keep the ball rolling. They're looking at a 2023 project for this development. We've already had meetings in-house with departmental comments to make sure that changes are made to the plan so that when it comes to you, it's a more appropriate plan. Obviously, variances will be necessary, as the petitioner had indicated. But those are the two items that we have.
Thank you. Any other questions, comments, discussion from our commissioners? If there are no other questions or comments, is there a motion to adjourn?
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. No oppositions. Meeting is adjourned.
Thank you.